Hello, my name's Lorraine Ellis. I'm the head of science at Newton Moore Senior High School, Bunbury, WA. Well, my philosophy on science teaching and student learning of science is very much about making it relevant, hands-on, very much based around the scientific method approach, and also very much having expertise, people who have got a passion for their subject, which will then pass on to the students, and also very much strongly behind all of that is linking the relevance to the community and to industry so that students can see the flow on of science in their everyday life. This is an example of our hands-on approach to science for our students. We've developed a native garden, and the students have designed and constructed and built a native pond. It's a solar pond. And the fish which we have actually put in here have been bred by the students as part of our native fish breeding program. Students breed the fish in these enclosures, then we go and monitor the wetlands and waterways in Bunbury, do the water testing, macroinvertebrates, quality control, and then release the fish for the control of the mosquitoes. We also have a license to breed the threatened Bolston pygmy perch. We work in partnership with Murdoch University. There's not many of these little fish around, so we're actually building up a breeding stock so that Murdoch can study the DNA and see where they should be re-released. Well, I guess that the main instigator, the main driving force, was setting up and establishing the Science Horizon Specialist Program, and then more recently the Engineering Approved Specialist Program. As part of our Science Horizons, one of the extensions programs is called the Marine Managers Program, and we've worked with the marine biologist at the Dolphin Centre, Murdoch University, and the students go out a number of times throughout the year, and what we're doing, we're collecting data for them, identifying the dolphin population in Kambana Bay, and they do this by taking photographs of the dorsal fins of the dolphins, and we can actually name them and identify them in their pods. We also record the type of behaviour. As well as the actual mammals, we also analyse the water as well, and we've got the data of the shipping and when the harbour's been dredged, just to link in all the human impact on the dolphin populations. And we also, alongside the Kambana Bay, is the Leshnog Inlet, where we have the most southern group of white mangroves, so the students are involved in studying and researching, and our aim is to develop a macroinvertebrate sensitivity index for that area. The wetlands program began a long time ago, back in 1997. The students have helped to revegetate, clear out weeds, and it's now a thriving living ecosystem. We use it as an outdoor classroom. As you can see, we've got our science students here doing macro counts. We do monthly frog trapping and water testing as well from year 8 to 12. Most significantly though, it's an opportunity for schools across the district who come in here and book workshops where our students practice kids teaching kids, and they actually do little circuit activities through the wetlands. I was also a leader in the school for Microsoft innovations, and I was involved in setting up the Microsoft partnerships across Australia. And one of the programs which really attracted the students and caught our imagination was the Deforest Action Program.
Another one of the fantastic programs that we've done at Newton Moore is the Microsoft Deforest Action to help the orangutans. We use video chat to talk to people over in Borneo, and we learnt about how endangered they are and what they're going through and all the cruelty. One of the activities we did was learning how to cut palm oil out of our diets, and it's really helped as part of a global action to help orangutans and all of us understand around the world.
I guess one of the things, me as a leader, is that I've actually been able to develop leaders within my teaching staff, and a number of them have won awards, including Microsoft Innovative Teacher of the Year, WA Premier's Teacher of the Year, and one of them actually went from the Microsoft Innovative Teacher to become a runner-up in the Global Microsoft Award in Washington. So that was a huge achievement. And there are a few others. I guess the pinnacle of being a science department was the Eureka Science Award. The Eureka Awards is the prestigious awards run by the Australian Museum, and this is the awards which recognise scientists from across Australia. So the science teaching to be put on a plateau with scientists is, like I said, the pinnacle of it's a combination of not only teaching but also science and spreading that science into the students and community. Apart from our staff, our students have also been extremely successful. They've been to Sweden a couple of times for the Stockholm Junior Water Prize. They've also won the Eureka Awards as well. When you're delivering an approved specialist program, you've got to extend these students, you've got to challenge them. And one of the ways you can do that is by international travel.
I love the opportunities which this program provides me. Recently this year, I have been to Singapore for an international United Nations youth conference. And that is one of many of the experiences and opportunities which this science program allows me to do.
I guess the advantage of having two approved specialist programs and having that inspiration and having staff around you who are motivated in the classroom, there's been an obvious impact on our numbers of students who are uptaking science and carrying on with upper school. Also, when we look at our graduation, where are they going from year 12, a lot of them, especially in the top 10 students, the top percentage are all doing science or engineering. And the flow on is not just for the top extended students. The other students also get the benefits. They also get to use all the equipment that we acquire through our grants and our hard work of winning awards and things like that. So the rub off is for everyone.